bottom, Ellsbury at the top. They've been looking for that speed dynamic, and maybe they have it.
It does change, and it's a nice dynamic, because sometimes teams go totally speed or totally power. Yankees could actually do both. So they could set the table first time around, and when it goes 9-1, it becomes a circular lineup, which they haven't really had in the last year or so. But if you have Gardner at number 9 and Ellsbury at number 1, that's pretty good.
Yeah, and Ellsbury is the guy who, Michael, not only does he steal bases, the guy never gets caught. Right. I mean, like an 85% success rate, that's the kind of guy you want running.
All right, time for the press conference to begin. Let's get up to the dais and the manager of media relations, Jason Zillow. Jason.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jason Zillow, and welcome to Yankee Stadium. We have more people than ever watching us or listening to us today's press conference. Of course, the YES Network and MLB Network and Yankees.com. We also have fans listening on the radio on WFAN, our newest broadcast partner. On behalf of the entire Yankees organization, I'd like to extend a warm holiday greeting to all of you. It's a wonderful holiday season, and it's a great day to be here. There's another season that's been taking place the last couple of weeks, and that's baseball's hot stove season. And for Yankees fans, the stove has definitely been cooking. 8 days ago, we introduced catcher Brian McCann, and today we welcome another premier player to the pinstripes. With the addition of Jacoby Ellsbury and his vast talents, it's just one more reason for Yankees fans to, you know, look past some of this cold weather and start thinking about February 14th, which is the day pitchers and catchers report to Tampa, Florida, George M. Steinbrenner Field, to start a new season. With that, I'd like to introduce everyone on the dais, beginning to my far left, which is Senior Vice President and General Manager Brian Cashman, Yankees Chief Operating Officer Lon Trost, and President Randy Levine, and of course, Managing General Partner Hal Steinbrenner. To my immediate right is Yankees Manager Joe Girardi, Jacoby Ellsbury, our guest of honor, and his wife, Kelsey, Yankees Senior Vice President and Assistant General Manager Gene Afterman, and Jacoby's representative Scott Boras. Scott, thank you for being here today. Before I turn this over, there's a few Yankee season ticket holders that are with us today, and I'd be remiss not to acknowledge them. They're not on the dais, but I think everybody in the organization, I can speak on behalf of them and say that they're a big thrust for us to bring exciting days like today to fruition. And I want to, I'm not sure where you are, but I want to welcome you and say thank you. With that, I'd like to turn it over to Yankees GM Brian Cashman.
Well, welcome everybody. We're excited. You know, we have a lot of work to do, and that starts with getting, you know, as much great talent in the fold as we possibly can. We were here, you know, recently with Brian McCann, and now we're very proud to be also bringing another dynamic, I think is a great word to use. It's a word that keeps being repeated over and over again when I talk to a lot of our people, and a lot of people who had Jacoby up in Boston. He's a dynamic player, someone that obviously can make a difference on the offensive and defensive side, someone that we have seen up close and personal for many years on the wrong side of the rivalry. So we look forward to him being one of many pieces to do a very important puzzle as we move forward in our efforts to try to continue the winning tradition here in the Bronx. So with that, I really do appreciate having the opportunity to welcome Jacoby Ellsbury and his wife Kelsey to the New York Yankee family. And we look forward to a lot of enjoyment in the years coming forward. So welcome. Before I introduce Joe, I'd like to provide Kelsey with a warm welcome of flowers. So if there they are right here. With that, I'd like to turn it over to the man who will benefit the most, I think, of it next to our fan base, Joe Girardi, our manager, who will have a lot of opportunity to smile when he writes that lineup together and have this player's name in that lineup. Joe?
Thanks, Brian. It seems like each week my job gets a little easier on how I'm going to fill out our lineup card. But when you think about adding players to your lineup, you think about adding players that are going to provide an impact, at least on one side of the ball. We're fortunate because we have a guy that's going to do it on both sides of the ball. And I've been able to witness that 19 times over the last 6 years each year. I've seen him get base hits. I've seen him hit home runs. I've seen him steal second. I've seen him steal third. And I even had the pleasure of watching him steal home off of Andy Pettit when I was standing right behind him and we were all screaming at Andy. Seen him make great catches that have changed the complexion of the scores between the Red Sox and Yankees. And that's why I'm so excited to have him in our lineup on a daily basis, because there's so many different ways that he can beat you, whether it's with his power or his speed or his glove. So, Jacoby, you are going to make my job a lot easier. You no longer are a thorn in my side. You are a flower in our clubhouse, and I'm happy to have you. So come on up.
Bob Lorenz back with you. This is always the moment of the big reveal at the press conferences for the Yankees. What number will Jacoby Ellsbury wear? You see the photo op with Joe Girardi and Jacoby Ellsbury with the jersey. And, Joe's going to make us wait as Ellsbury tries on the jersey. Was number 2 in Boston. Originally started as number 46, switched it to number 2. It'll wear number 22. Checked with his wife, Kelsey, for her approval. She looked very happy. Pinstripes always slimming.
Right over here.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it.
Kind words.
You got the hat too? Throw the hat on. All right. Yeah. Well,
over here.
Well, I'm excited to be a New York Yankee. Definitely very excited for my family and I. I know Kelsey's excited to be here. You guys have treated me so great all day today. Very, very appreciative. I'm excited for this opportunity, coming to a storied franchise. Looking outside today, seeing the banners on the wall, seeing the great players that have played here. It's just a truly honor. I want to thank Hal Steinbrenner. Definitely a pleasure to the Steinbrenner family. Randy Levine, Cash, Joe, it's an honor, and I'm excited to go out there. Can't wait to get to spring training, get to work, and meet my teammates. And hopefully, when it's all said and done, we can hoist that trophy above our head. That being said, excited to be here.
Okay, folks, we can take questions. We have wireless mics. If you wouldn't mind raising your hand and introducing yourself to Jacoby before you ask the question, that would be great.
Hi, Jacoby. Jack Curry, Yes Network. Could you take us through your thought process when you first hear from the Yankees in the offseason, and then as those negotiations escalate and you're saying to yourself, wow, this is coming closer to being a reality?
Right. Well, from the get-go, the Yankees showed a great interest in me and let me know that they really wanted me. And from that point on, everything moves very fast and it was exciting. I always enjoyed playing here. I love the tradition. The fans, it's kind of nice having them on my side now. But just a great place to play, honored to be here and excited.
Go ahead and take that.
Hi, Jacoby. Sweeney Murdy from WFAN. Congratulations.
Thank you.
7-year commitment means you're now going to be part of the next core of the Yankees, and I wondered how you felt about that responsibility and that leadership that comes with that.
Right. It's exciting. You know, I know a lot of the guys just playing against them. I talked to them. You know, they told me, you know, you're going to love being a New York Yankee. It's unbelievable. And, yeah, I mean, that was that's important to me. I'm excited to be here for an extended period of time, building that group, coming together. So I'm looking forward to the next 7-8 years, definitely.
Jacoby, Mark Feinstein with the New York Daily News. You joined the latest line of a Red Sox coming over to the Yankees. You've seen Johnny Damon and some other guys go through it. What have been your impressions of the Yankees from the other side of the field, and what do you think it's going to be like the first time you go back to Boston?
Well, yeah, it's definitely been done before. you know, yeah, I mean, yeah, I have nothing but great things to say, you know, about my whole team. And I'm just, you know, truly honored to be here. Obviously, you know, it's going to be fun when I go back to Boston. But, you know, I'm excited to be here, you know, excited. You know, I know the rivalry being familiar with AL East. It's just going to be an exciting time. And, you know, definitely I could just happy to put on this jersey and hat.
Hi, Jacoby. Ed Randall with WFAN and Sirius and MLB.com. Congratulations. As you took off the uniform, which was soaked with champagne, did you ever have a sense of irony that maybe I'm not going to be wearing this uniform again?
Well, I mean, every time I play, every time I step on that field, you know, I don't take it for granted. You know, I felt I had 7 great years there playing. And, yeah, last year was a great season. You know, that's what it's all about, is winning championships. And, you know, feel very fortunate to be part of that team. You know, 7 great years. Now I'm looking forward to the next 7, 8 years of my career. And, you know, hopefully we can, like you said, be holding that trophy.
You mentioned you were part of a very successful, Lloyd Carroll from the Queens Chronicle, Jacoby. You were part of a very successful organization, an organization that certainly spends money, invests in its resources. Did you feel that Boston made a good offer to retain your services? I'm kind of curious. It certainly had to be a comfort level playing there as long as you did.
Right. Well, you know, I'm not really going to get into to that right now. But, yeah, I mean, it was 7 great years. You know, the fans treated me great. You know, the guys in the clubhouse, you know, those are relationships that I'll have for the rest of my life, regardless of what uniform I'm in or what uniform they're in. And then the 2 world championships, you know, started my career with the world championship, ended my tenure there with a championship. So, you know, unbelievable, you know, first spot of my career. So definitely excited to, you know, for the next chapter.
Take one or two more.
Jacoby, congratulations. I'm Brendan Cuddy with NJ.com. A lot of guys have made that Red Sox to Yankees jump. Did you consult any of them before coming over here and talk to them about how to do that?
Well, I talked to not the guys that made the jump. I talked to previous players that have played with New York that are currently with the Yankees, and they said you'll love it here. You'll enjoy, you'll embrace the city. You'll love playing here, and they showed that they wanted me from the get-go. And from that moment on, you know, I was definitely excited to become a New York Yankee.
Hey, Jacoby. This is Nolan Silbernagle from WFUV Radio. What are you looking forward to most being a Yankee?
I mean, you know, I talk about a lot the tradition, the great players that have played here, the commitment to winning. That's important. And just, you know, going out there and having a good time. I mean, the guys that have played here, talking to them, they just told me, you're gonna love playing here. And the chance to win championships, you know, the chance to hoist that trophy. I know I talk about that a lot, and the chance to win, their commitment to winning. And that's what really excites me.
Okay, folks, thank you for joining us. That will conclude the formal portion of the press conference. Again, from all of us up here, to all of you, have a safe and happy holiday season. Thank you.